very good afternoon to all of you. Today we will discuss about some of the methods which are used for solving the recurrences. One of the method used for solving the recurrence is a master method. Apart from master method, there are three other methods also, that is recursion tree method, substitution method, as well as iteration method. First we will discuss about the master method, then move ahead with the drawbacks of master method to the recursion tree method, then the drawbacks of both the master and the recursion tree method will try to resolve with the help of iteration and substitution methods. Now in my lecture I will discuss about what is master method, matlab what type of recurrences are solved using master method. Second step is, what is the master theorem? What are the cases of the master theorem? Third step is, some of the examples I will discuss with each and every case of the master theorem. Next step is to identify those recurrences that cannot be solved using a master theorem. These are the four steps which we will follow. First, बिफोर मूविंग अहेड हम यहां पे ये जज करेंगे कि किस तरह के रेकरेंसेस मास्टर मेथड से सॉल्व करे जा सकते हैं. जैसे टी एन इज इक्वल टू ए टी एन बाई बी प्लस एफ एन. दिस इज द फॉर्म ऑफ अ मास्टर मेथड. This is a recurrence, or this is the form which can be solved using a master method. Now, this Tn is also a function, this Fn is also a function. And this Atn by b is what? There is a problem of size n that is divided into sub-problems with this type of a recurrence. This is repeatedly going on. Now, ab isme ho kya raha hai? Ye mera jo size of problem hai, wo n hai. प्रॉब्लम का जो साइज है वो मेरा यहां पे n है. अब ये जो मेरा a है इसका मतलब है कि एक n साइज की प्रॉब्लम मेरी इतनी सब प्रॉब्लम्स में डिवाइड हुई है. मतलब मेरी n साइज की प्रॉब्लम्स कितनी सब प्रॉब्लम्स में डिवाइड हो रही है, वो एक या एक से ज्यादा हो सकती हैं. तो हमारे पास कंडीशन है a जो है वो ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू 1 होना चाहिए. मतलब एक n प्रॉब्लम मेरी n में ही डिवाइड हो रही है, या फिर मेरी क्या नाम है, n प्रॉब्लम 2n बाई 2 में, या इस तरह से 2 में 3 में 4 में इस तरह से डिवाइड हो रही है. मतलब a इज बेसिकली नंबर ऑफ सब प्रॉब्लम्स. नाउ व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस n बाई b? दिस n बाई b इज अ साइज ऑफ अ सब प्रॉब्लम. That is, n by b is a size of a sub-problem. Now, this n by b can be in floor as well as a ceiling, but there will be no variation in complexity if this appears in floor and ceiling. So, n is the size of a problem, a is the number of problems, and n by b is the size of the sub-problem. And b should be greater than 1. This is basically the conditions which we are given to us. That is, a should be greater than equal to 1 and b should be greater than 1. Now, what is a meaning of this fn? Fn is a function which defines the cost of dividing a problem. Matlab, a problem ko divide karna. मैं इसको ऐसे लिखता हूं, मान लो मेरे पास एरे में 8 एलिमेंट हैं, ये चार चार में डिवाइड हुए, दो दो में डिवाइड हुए, फिर एक एक में डिवाइड हुए, और जब ये एक एक में डिवाइड हो गए तो यहां पे मैंने सॉर्टिंग परफॉर्म करके वापस मर्ज हुए, और फिर इनमें आपस में सॉर्टिंग, ये वापस मर्ज, ये वापस मर्ज, और ये वापस कंक्लूड हो गए 8. अब यहां से यहां तक मैंने डिवाइड ऑपरेशन परफॉर्म किया, इसके बाद मैंने इसके अंदर एक कॉन्करेंट कंबाइन ऑपरेशन परफॉर्म किया, मतलब अगर मैं अपने एग्जाम्पल के हिसाब से समझूं तो fn क्या है, fn एक वो फंक्शन है जो मुझे ये बता रहा है कि कितनी कॉस्ट लग रही है एक n साइज की प्रॉब्लम को सब प्रॉब्लम्स में डिवाइड करने में, प्लस उन सारी सब प्रॉब्लम्स के सब सॉल्यूशंस को ऑब्टेन करके एक एंटायर प्रॉब्लम के सॉल्यूशन को ऑब्टेन करने में जो कॉस्ट लग रही है उसे हम fn कह रहे हैं। बेसिकली अगर बिल्कुल आसान लैंग्वेज में समझें तो fn मतलब एक प्रॉब्लम को सब प्रॉब्लम्स में डिवाइड करना, प्लस उन सारी सब प्रॉब्लम्स के सब सॉल्यूशंस को ऑब्टेन करते हुए एक एंटायर प्रॉब्लम के सॉल्यूशन को ऑब्टेन करने में जो कॉस्ट लग रही है उसे हम fn कह रहे हैं। अब यहां से हमने सिर्फ इतना सीखा कि मास्टर मेथड का जो रेकरेंस है वो इस फॉर्म में है, ए टी एन बाई बी प्लस fn। ए मतलब कितनी नंबर ऑफ सब प्रॉब्लम्स हैं, एन बाई बी मतलब साइज ऑफ सब प्रॉब्लम, और fn मेरी कॉस्ट है डिवाइड और कंबाइन करने में जो लग रही है। अब कंडीशंस मुझे पता है, ए जो है वो हमेशा वन या वन से बड़ा होगा और बी हमेशा हमारा वन से बड़ा होना चाहिए। अब नेक्स्ट स्टेप है हमारा ये डिस्कस करने का कि व्हाट आर द केसेस ऑफ द मास्टर थ्योरम। केसेस ऑफ मास्टर थ्योरम, फर्स्ट वी विल राइट हियर द रेकरेंस टी एन ए टी एन बाय बी प्लस एफ एन वेयर A should be greater than equal to 1 and B should be greater than 1. This is basically the form of the master method. Now, case 1. What we are doing basically, there is a recurrence Tn, A Tn by B plus Fn. There can be three possible cases. One in which the time obtained from this is greater than this. Other one, the time obtained from this and this is same. Third one, the time obtained or time taken by this is less than the time taken by this. There are three possibilities that can happen. Either this is greater than this, these both are equal, or either fn is greater than atn by b. How we compute atn by b, we will see this. There are three possibilities that can be delivered from there. Now, first possibility, agar dekhe, if fn is equal to, fn is what? Function, jo fn given hame, is equal to big O of n log b a minus some constant. Now, this big O, we all know that this is upper bound. N log BA, this B is this and this A is the number of subproblems. And minus some constant. That is, if we take an example here, that is Tn is equal to 4Tn by 2 plus N. Now, what we are doing, this Fn is N. What is this n log BA? This n log BA will be obtained from here. Now, what is n log BA? Big O of n log base 2 of 4. Now, what is this? N log base 2 of 4 will be n square. Now, this is n square minus some constant. Now, if these two things is to be equal, now this constant should be 1. That is, with some constant with E greater than 0. Now E is 1. Therefore, this both the terms is equal. Then we can say that after analyzing this part with this example, we obtain that n log BA is greater than Fn. There are multiple ways to see this. This is basically a case. This is an example which I have shown you within reference to this. And this is a direct method, that is L log BA is either greater than Fn, less than Fn or equal to Fn. These are the three possible cases. Now the first case is that the N log BA is greater than Fn. Now, if N log BA is greater than Fn, we can directly compute from this that this part is N square, which I have obtained from here, and this part is N. If running time of this part is greater than the running time of this part, then but obvious, the complexity will be big O of n square, ya theta of n square. Hope this is the first case which you all have understood. Now, what exactly is the case going on? That is, if Fn is equal to big O of n log BA minus some constant with E greater than 0, then Tn should be theta of n square. That is, I have covered the first case in which n log BA is greater than Fn. Now, for the second case, in the second case, I will discuss about case number 2. In the second case, N log BA is equal to Fn. Here, if N log BA, if Fn is equal to N log BA, that is, a constant is equal to 0, then Tn is equal to theta of n log BA dot log n. Now, what is the meaning of this case? Let us take an example. Tn is equal to 4tn by 2 plus n square. Now, what we obtained from this? This is n square. What is the function? This is n square. Now, this n log BA is equal to Fn. This is case number 2. If n log BA is equal to Fn, then what we have to do? We have to simply multiply this with the help of log n. This is case number 2. Now, we will discuss about the third case in which n log BA is less than Fn. That is, if third case, if Fn is equal to omega of n log BA plus some constant, this constant is greater than 0. Now, what we have done as of now, n log BA is greater than Fn, that is first case. N log BA is equal to Fn, that is second case. And the third case is N log BA is less than Fn. Now, what we are doing here? N log BA plus some constant in order to make both of them equal. Let us take an example. Tn is equal to 4tn by 2 plus n cube. If we analyze it quickly, this part N log BA will give n square. This part is n cube. This is N log BA. This is Fn. Now, Fn is greater than n log BA. Therefore, we can say that its running time will be Tn is equal to theta of Fn, that is Tn is equal to theta of n cube. Now, how we will write this with the help of our theorem? That is, this is an example which I have considered. Now, if Fn is equal to omega of n log BA plus constant with E greater than 0, and there is an additional condition, and if A Fn by B less than fn equal to c of fn for c less than 1 and large n, then pn is equal to theta of fn, where afn by b less than equal to c of fn is a regularity condition in case number 3. So directly if we think about this, if fn is omega of n log ba plus constant, then this fn is greater than this part. Therefore, Tn is equal to theta of Fn. Now, what exactly is the meaning of this regularity condition? Why we have imposed this regularity condition in case number 3? How, what type of a problems are need to be solved with, what type of recurrence are required to be solved with the help of this regularity condition? We will see in the next lecture. As per this lecture, I have covered what exactly is a form of master method and what are the 3 cases. I have discussed only one basic example of each of the case. In the next lecture, I will discuss about more examples as well as discuss about the drawbacks of the master method. Thank you.